jam. You are near, just like me. They long to be close to you. Why do stars fall down from the sky every time you walk by? Just like me, they long to be close to you. On the day that you were born, the angels got together and decided to create a dream come true. So they sprinkle the dust in your head.
Quiet, my son. Quiet.
Who are you?
I am Mr. Muffles.
God?
No, Mr. Muffles. Yes, yes, my child.
But I didn't know what to do.
Think hard. Think very hard.
Well, I'm not sure. Who could it be? Whose fault could it be? Archie?
No, no. He helped you. He was one of the victims, along with you.
That is true. Well, it could have been Fat Pat.
Fat Pat was always looking out for you. He was a lovely chap. He saved the class. You've got it. You've finally got it.
Class, as you know, I am Miss Bentley, and things have changed. You've not seen me for a number of weeks. And why? Well, I was viciously assaulted by a extraterrestrial species, you know, we don't talk about that in this classroom. But no. No, there is a big change coming. You all now have to go by the free rules of Bentley. And the class is no longer a free roaming class. No longer. From now on, you go by the Bentley rules. Rule number one. You no longer have your own opinion. From now on, you have no free will. I tell you what to do, and you do it, because I'm Miss Bentley, and that's how I roll. You no longer have any rights. If I go up to you, and I hit you in the face, by the way, this is rule number two. I am entitled to hurt, abuse, and whip all of you whenever I feel like it. For example, I'm going to use one of you as my puppet.
I don't want her to pick me. I don't want to be abused.
Joseph! Come here!
Oh, she's not picked me, is she? Oh, good. I guess I'll come over then.
Now watch this, class. Whenever I feel like it, this'll be you. Bend over, Joseph! Bend over!
You want me to bend over? Okay.
Now watch carefully.
Oh, oh, Why?
That's how we roll around here. I can slap your bottoms. I can kick your teeth in. I can even shoot up the school. It's my choice. And now, for rule number 3. This is plain and simple. Basically, I can keep you here how far, how long I like. You're not allowed to leave the class until I say so, and that may be in 400 years or in a minute. It's my choice. I can leave whenever I like. But you lot, yeah, Miss Bentley can keep you here for as long as she wants. Good riddance. You're all horrible scumbag fools. And if I ever catch any of you breaking these 3 rules, you will suffer. And I don't just mean suffer. I mean you will take me and yourself to school. God. And you saw what happened to Archie, to Fat Pat, to Ryan, and Robert. So good riddance. The power of Miss Bentley runs through.
Hello, Miss Bentley.
What on earth you doing here, Robert?
I'm here, and I'm here for a purpose. I was told by the one up there, the god of everywhere. He told me, Mr. Muffles told me, that I should tell you that you should screw you, because you ruined everything. You put me to the middle of nowhere. And I met Seamus Hawking, who killed Archie. And I thought it was Archie's fault. But I was blinded. It was your fault, Miss Bentley. It was you all along. You're the one who tried all those times to bully me. All the way back to the alien times. And then you took me to school of court for something I didn't even do. It's not fair, and you made it like that.
Robert! I thought my sending of you to the middle of nowhere was, and still is, an indefinite death for you by my hands. Suffering brings joy to my heart. But you coming back changes my whole perspective. So, Robert, I'm going to make the biggest example of you that I have ever made on any student, making you never, never come back!
Miss Bentley, I'm not a fan of yours. You have crossed a line.
Because Miss Bentley is insulted.
Screw you, Miss Bentley, I hate your guts!
You're a spelling boy!
Ow!
You're a terrible, terrible boy. And the rest of the class, this is your fate. This stupid, rebellious boy, I have made an example of him. He will never get up.
Get up, my child. She is nothing, she is nothing.
He's right, Mr. Muffles is right.
He will never get up because I have made the biggest example of him I have ever
got to stand
made of anybody, and that's
you.
get.
What? Robert, you have just made the biggest mistake of your young life, little brat.
What was that? What? Ah, I hear something. Something's happening.
You just hate me. So you know what? I feel buzzed. I feel like that I'm in the right. The first time I've ever felt like hitting someone was the right thing to do. Because I hate you, and I'm not afraid of you anymore. I'm not afraid of you at all.
Drama! Drama! This could be huge. This could be huge. All I need to know. I can make tons of cash out of this.
You know what? I've had it up to here with you. I challenge you, Robert. I challenge you to an old-fashioned fight!
A fight! A fight between Robert and Miss Bentley. The name speaks for itself.
The fight is on! Bring it. Bring it, I tell you. I'll take you on any day.
What? Well, come on, then. You know what? I'll fight you anywhere it takes you. Come on. I'll take you on. We'll make a big fight. We'll be bigger than anything. Miss Bentley versus Robert. Bring it on, then.
It's been good, great. Utter hype. That's it. The tash. Marvin Sparks has got to tell us the world. I've got to make this a memorable event. And the fight will be something magnificent.
I'm going to make you suffer the embarrassment because you, Robert, are nothing but scum!
I'm going to destroy you and turn your legacy into foolishness. No more Mr. Nice Boy!
I will commentate. I will interview. I will make this a huge event, the press conference, the sellings, the merchandise. It's all me because the Tash is one with the world. Ready!
And welcome, and this is a big, big fight night today. This is the day. This is the day of Miss Bentley versus Robert. A big hype fight that has been going on for like a few hours, but still, it's big. It's big, and there's no one else who can miss it. No one else, because in the demand tonight, there will be the fight. And I, and somebody else, I don't know, will find him. Gandalf the Scot will. Gandalf and me, we will commentate on the match. So, basically, what you need to do to get tickets is to go off and put your money to the person, and they'll give you a ticket. Well, that's how the world works, I suppose. So Marvin Sparks, you can speak in here, and you'll enjoy the fight. I hear there's stuff going on. Yes, there's interviews going on right now. So enjoy.
Welcome back to WWE News. I'm Sally Westerman, your reporter, and there's a massive, smashing fight going on. If only I knew that anyone who was looking for this fight that I could perhaps interview. And oh, would you look at that? Come with me, cameraman.
Yo, sniffing undead. What do you think of the fight?
The fight? I say, the fight is going to be brilliant. I think it's going to be very good.
Yes, I also think the fight will be brilliant. And who do you think will win out of our two competitors?
You mean Miss Bentley and Robert?
Yes, I mean Miss Bentley and Robert. Obviously, it's a huge event. Everyone would know that.
Well, of course, yes, you too. And, I think impossibly. I'm saddened with Miss Bentley. She's a brave soul. Yes.
I'm more of a Robert gang myself. Fuck you! What makes you think that Miss Bentley could beat our boy Robert?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Basically, you look at Miss Bentley's eyes, and she's so beautiful. She's a last class. Her ass is beautiful. That's racist.
Yes, per se. However, Robert is handsome, powerful, just like a true war hero, darling.
Oh, well, a true war hero indeed.
Yes, that's quite right. This has been WWE News.
Get out of my way!
Right, this is WWE News, and this is Martin Sparks, you can hear. And we're in the press conference with the two fighters here tonight. In this corner, we have Robert. And in this comment below, we have Miss Bentley.
Yes, that's me.
So I'm going to be having a word with him. Robert, I need to speak to you because people are saying you're the underdog. So I need to ask, what do you plan on doing in this fight?
Well, you see, people say I'm the underdog, but I don't think so. In my opinion, I think I might be the stronger of the two because I'm younger, and I think I'm tough for my age. And I think I can do it. I really think I can do it because I have the gut and the determination, and I have the physique.
Well, that's all well and good, but do you think you can pull it off?
Well, yes, I think I can pull it off. If I dig down deep and believe that I can do it, then I'm bound to do it. There's no hope in me not.
I like that. Belief. Well, WWE News has to speak to Miss Bentley as well. But Bentley, do you plan on being in any way civil to this boy? Or is this a blood feud?
This is, by all means, a blood feud. I don't want to create any sporting attitude with that boy. That boy deserves to die.
A blood feud, you say? Well, are we expecting brutality?
Yes. Brutality is the only thing I will bring to that boy. He will be hit, and hit some more. Because Miss Bentley has made it clear to him that he will never win because I am brutal. And when I want something, I get it.
Well, all right then. The message is clear. This is a blood feud. There's no sympathy for either one of the fighters. They both are just getting to beat each other.
The arena is free.
Well, that's all well and good, and I really hope you enjoy the fight tonight. And, there's one more interview I hear. Yes, Sally Westman is on the screen. Yes, Sally, go.
Thank you, Coach. Now, it's me again, Sally Westerman, your WWE News spokesperson. And, as you all know, it's fight night, and the buzz is at an all-time high for Miss Bentley versus Robert. And here, we have another thrill-looking individual, follow me. And we're going to be asking him a few questions about tonight's fight. So, who do you think is going to win between Miss Bentley and Robert? Miss Bentley and Robert. Okay, well, thank you. I don't know. And we are going to be looking and streaming the fight tonight, live at 7. Good night.
Wait!
Cigarette. What is it, young man?
I have one more thing to say.
Yes?
There's a reason why I think this Bentley's going to win. And I'm going to tell you now and the rest of the world. You see, this Bentley, I've always had a crush on her. She's beautiful. She has a liquid ass. And do you know what? You know what? Screw you for thinking it's Robert. Robert's gonna die tonight and I want him dead. Miss Bentley, when she spanked my bottom, that's when I felt the world spilling into me. And I even know that there's millions of people watching me right now. I don't understand. Miss Bentley is beautiful. And she's going to win the fight. Don't cut me off. Don't cut me off.
Ah, you little son of a bitch, your ass.
Right, well, enjoy the fight tonight. Fight. Yes, enjoy it. All right,
Modern Sparks Attached is signing out.
Just hang on.
Alright, the fight is about to start. The fight is about to start, and I'm commentating alongside Gandalf the Scot.
Alright, Marvin. I'm here.
And we are going to speak, and we're going to commentate, and we're going to adjust what we're saying on this fight, basically. Sorry, I hope you can hear me at home. So basically, let's get on with it. The first entrant. Looking strong indeed is Robert. He's looking more buff than ever. He never was buff. But now, next entrant. Here. She is in a full dress. Well, bloody hell, I guess that's how confident she is, I suppose.
And the special guest referee is Ryan from Graceful Tie. And both opponents are warming up right now, and right now in the game, what would you say the mindsets of both Miss Bentley and Robert are, Gandalf?
Let's see, they're doing alright.
Alright, so the fight's about to begin.
And we're off! And coming out of the gate, there is Robert running up and let's see what's going to happen now. Dodging a shot as Miss Bentley. Oh, big jab.
That's what I thought.
Oh, goodness me.
I'm going to knock you.
Oh, no, another big shot. And Robert's down.
I told you so. There's no hope for that young boy. He's way over his big head.
Could this be an early case of a KO? Could Robert be in his last stand?
Well, I would hope so. Look who is victorious. Don't bother getting up. There's no point. I'll just evaporate you from the world. And accept defeat. Because I'm Miss Bentley and I always win.
I won't give up.
In this taunting going on by Miss Bentley,
no,
and Robert could give up now, but oh my goodness, no. No, Robert's getting back up.
Any
swings,
he
misses?
Still? You think you're hard?
Oh, no, shot! And Robert's right back down and onto his knees now. Good grief, this is not looking good for the young boy.
Robert, the whole world can see you, but nobody cares about you. You're just a big fool. You have nothing. I am the winner. I'm always victorious.
You are a silly, stupid boy. You're not, my friend.
I'd like not to see your face. You have disgraced me.
And Robert, you are stupid. You're a stupid boy. You're just a big, dumb loser. What a coward. Coward and a big, dumb loser.
In school calls of love.
This could be the end of the fight now. It's not looking good for Ryan. Oh, Robert. Oh, my goodness. Wait, what's going on? No! Oh, my God! No way!
Oh!
Miss Bentley's down! Miss Bentley! No way! Oh, my word!
What is this? Amazing!
Smile, the what we go through.